Right, hello. So, this is Jim, King James. This is my podcast. You're listening. Thanks for tuning in. I just wanted to throw out some shout-outs to local artists from the Bronx where I'm from because I like to support local music. Of course, if you haven't already, check it out. See Nico Zico's, or I think it's Zico Nico. It's either Zico Nico or Nico Zico, but he has an amazing song called, I think it's called That Bag. Like a bag, like luggage or whatever. It's called That Bag, and he's explaining throughout the song how he's running to it. I think the bag is like a metaphor for money or grinding or hustle or whatever. But it's fucking amazing. In the opening line, he says, I smack the ass and then I dab. So basically, he smacks the booty of some thought, and then he does the dab maneuver to evade. Essentially, he smacks the ass and he makes a quick dash forward, which I find very amusing. And I've been known to do that myself. When I go out to the club or whatever, I smack a woman behind when she turns around, obviously upset about it. I'm nowhere to be found like Batman. But that's another one. Zico Nico, you should check him out. The Gingerbread Man. Right, Gingerbread Man, just like the dessert, the treat for kids. As a rapper, goes by the Gingerbread Man. Amazing music. He's from the Bronx also. Catch up. That's his ad lib, his calling card. Just put in the Gingerbread Man and Bronx, and you'll see all his music. He's quite an eclectic fellow. His music is very cool, and I've been bumming it lately. Also, check out Young Bezel. The rapper, Young Bezel, like a watch, like a timepiece on your wrist. Check him out. His last track, Loyal, basically the caliber of your friends and your friendships. He's released a song about that, following an incident where he was slashed in the forehead. And he has quite a scar, like rather like the villain from Lion King. It's really ghastly and gnarly to look at, but the music is amazing. He's quite a rhyme spit. He's got bars for days. I could go on naming. You're Coney Brooks. You've got Illa the Sandman, he's amazing. The silverback of rap, Gorilla, mixtape is out now. I've completely fudged it out, but just check Illa the Sandman. Go on Facebook, whatever. Who else is very good? You've got the Kid Farid, obviously. He's a rapper as well as tattoo artist. Been shadowing him on his exploits lately. Having a very good time too. He's a great guy, very funny, very warm and inviting. Cool guy to be around. If you got the chance and you're in the Uptown Bronx around White Plains and 228th Street, you should check out his shop. It's, well, hit him up first because you're not supposed to just kind of just swagger into his shop. He should know you're coming, so contact him first and then whatever. But me and him are quite good friends, so I tend to just kind of swagger in there whenever I feel like a bit of a jerk, but he's always quite welcoming. And lastly, check out my man Torch of Maybach Music, Triple C's. I haven't heard much news about him. He stays pretty low-key, but he's definitely one of the people in the Bronx who put everyone on. And if you think different, then you're a piece of shit and you should just fuck off. But check out Torch super hard. Check out all his work with Maybach Music. Check out the videos that are directed with him. Not toot my own horn, but someone has to. Right, yeah. Bronx artists, local hip-hop artists, amazing stuff. A Boogie is blowing up. I don't have to mention that, but I just did, so there you go. He also raps about bags. It's like bag season or something. Everyone's talking about the bags. I don't have a bag, but if I did, I would run to it.